Every month, the Laker Review staff works hard to bring you many features, such as news, viewpoint, entertainment, sports, and a center spread. The Laker Review, coming soon to a classroom near you.
What's going on, Laker Nation? Guess what's just around the corner? That's right, Lakers, it's almost time for the much-anticipated Thanksgiving break.
And don't forget Black Friday shopping. In fact, we'll be taking a look at Shoppers Gone Wild in today's show. But up first, a rundown of the Laker accomplishments.
Meanwhile, the CCHS varsity academic team took home more victories this week. The Lakers beat Graves County 33-18, lost a close one to Marshall County with 27-28, but rebounded to defeat the powerful Paducah Tillman with a score of 38-22. Reporter Tristan Cole takes us behind the scenes of the academic team competition.
Hypothetical, red one.
Subjective.
Correct, your bonus. This battle was fought on the grounds of Chalmette Plantation.
I think I first got interested in it because I had a couple of friends that did it. Landon and Hudson did it first, and I was like, okay, so that sounds pretty cool what they were doing. I think they both did quick recall, and so I thought I'd try it. I did I think math written assessment, and I really liked it. I did pretty good. I think I placed, so I was like, okay, I'll try quick recall. So that's kind of how I got involved with that.
Richard III at what battle?
Battle of Hastings.
I'd say we're doing really well. During the regular season, we've won a lot more than we've lost. We've lost only two of our quick recall matches, and we've won the rest of them. So I think that's a really good start.
Name this depiction of isolation by Edward Hopper. Correct.
Our quick recall team varsity has beat the toughest opponent in the region. Last week we beat Paducah Tillman 38-22, and we've also beat Graves and a host of other schools already this season.
In their latest match yesterday afternoon, the Lakers finished with a complete sweep over their toughest competition yet. They defeated Region 1 opponents Paducah Tillman and Graves County, and Region 2 foe Madisonville North Hopkins. In fact, the final scores weren't even close. Congratulations, you guys.
A few weeks ago, several Japanese high school students visited our school, but did you know that another Japanese visitor made a formal appearance here at Calloway as well? Reporter Braxton Bogard tells us why this foreign dignitary made a visit from his Nashville, Tennessee office.
More than 40% of the foreign direct investment in Kentucky.
I really want them to play a lot of bridge between Japan and Kentucky. That's why I visit this wonderful school. Try to stress the importance of Japanese relations.
Motohiko Kato, a Japanese consul general headquartered in Nashville, Tennessee, recently brought his message to Calloway County High. He spoke about the economy between the U.S. and Japan and what both countries are doing to help others.
I thought what he said was cool. He kind of elaborated on some of the stuff we'd been learning in class.
We asked Mr. Kato about recent allegations accusing America's National Security Agency of wiretapping foreign government offices. Kato says it creates an image problem that the U.S. needs to work on.
United States should be the leader of the free world and maintain the wonderful reputations among the countries free in the free world.
Motohiko told the students about the past and future of the U.S.-Japan relationship.
Of course, we had a tragic history in the past, but now we are allied each other as a developed country and share the importance of just the human rights and the rule of law. We are working together to secure the peace and prosperity for the entire Asia-Pacific region.
Kato hopes that the younger generations will strengthen the bonds of America's relationship with other countries.
I want the young people to visit just Asia and other area so that you can understand the importance of foreign relations with these countries.
For Laker TV, I'm Braxton Bogard.
Don't go anywhere, Laker Nation. We're coming right back to more feature packages, including a look into the world of the Airsoft War Games.
And some crazy scenes from Black Friday, all coming up here on Laker TV.
We'll be right back.
While some teenagers resort to the first-person shooter video games to get their simulation game on, some students at Calloway like to take the action to the woods for a game of airsoft. For more info, let's toss it over to LakerTV reporter Logan Fry.
Airsoft is a war simulation hobby in which participants use artificial weapons to complete objectives which resemble military situations that can vary from capture the flag to team deathmatch to hostage rescue. But some people have some serious concerns about this game.
Come on, runner!
Airsoft is a sport similar to paintball, but that allows for high levels of realism in its weapons. Airsoft has gained traction in our area with the development of a local airsoft field in Paducah. I asked Laker junior Hunter Bailey how he got into the hobby.
I had this friend a long time ago. He moved, but he got me and a couple other friends into it, and we've just been playing for a while.
There have been incidents where airsoft guns were mistaken for actual firearms. Because of this, several state congresses have attempted to take the realism out of airsoft. However, doing this would take away from airsoft's only advantage over paintball, ultimately destroying the hobby. Airsoft fanatics like Hunter believe there is a much simpler solution.
You should be an adult about it and be responsible. Treat it like it's a real gun.
So if airsoft seems interesting to you, remember to leave the orange tip on your gun and bring along a mask and gun case as well. For Laker TV, I'm Logan Fry.
Nice, man.
Thank you, Logan. Thanksgiving is a day Americans give thanks for things they have. And the day after has become the day Americans rush out to get more things. It's called Black Friday, and reporter Zach Lava says it can get pretty crazy in some places.
Well, it's almost that time of year again. Early mornings after Thanksgiving, shoppers will flock, and sometimes even trample, to get the newest gadget or clothing style. Some will run and get the newest game console, tablet, or smartphone.
It's what led us to create Touch ID.
People are lining up earlier and earlier every year. In fact, Walmart is even starting at 6 p.m. on Thanksgiving Day. When it comes to Black Friday, sometimes people can get just a little bit out of hand.
Carmelo, one guy threatened to stab people.
I just got hit in the face with a bag.
Hey, don't push it on my head!
You zombies are the reason that Thanksgiving and holidays are being destroyed. It's zombies like you that are causing these poor retail workers to have to sacrifice their Thanksgiving to serve idiots like you.
But all chaos aside, Black Friday is a great way to save money on all the gifts you have for your loved ones this holiday season. For Laker TV, I'm Zach Halaba.
We really don't. The truth is that this year, Black Friday deals launch much earlier than Black Friday or even Thanksgiving. But other bargain hunters argue that the week of December 8th to the 14th is the best time to shop for toys and clothing. Whichever it may be, we know one thing, a good deal is still a good deal. Still to come, Will Van Horn previews the new Hunger Games movie, and Selena Eric shows how Laker Cheer is preparing for regionals.
Right now, it's today's featured young music artist, and it seems to be that Trevor Jackson isn't the only Disney star to hit the top charts in music.
That's right, Madison. All the way from the sunny Cali State, singer, actor, and dancer Zendaya is our featured young artist this week. Her new single is called Replay. Let's check it out.
Hi, Laker sports fans. I'm Selena Eric. Now that fall sports have come to an end, it's time to introduce the athletes in the upcoming winter sports season. On Tuesday, November 26th at 6:30, Meet the Lakers is taking place here at Jeffrey Gymnasium. Meet the Lakers is not only for the high school athletes, but also for the middle school athletes. It's the kickoff for all the winter sports, including wrestling, swimming, fishing, dance, cheer, and girls and boys basketball. The state finals for a competitive cheerleading are coming up in December, and if the Laker cheer team wants to be there, they have to win their division this Saturday at regional competition at Madisonville North Hopkins. Besides the unexpected challenge, the Lakers are ready to show the judges what they got.
One of our senior captains, Lauren Dietz, fell at practice and dislocated her elbow. And so that has been a challenge because cheerleading is unique. It's not like football and basketball where if somebody gets hurt, you can take a sub off the bench and put that person in the game.
Another challenge facing the Lakers is the fact that the regional competition is earlier than usual. This is the first year that KPOS, the Kentucky Association of Pep Organization Sponsors, isn't governing cheer in Kentucky.
Now, KHSAA has sanctioned competition cheerleading as a sport. So those girls who compete for their high schools are considered athletes and have to follow a lot of the same standards, and the coaches have to follow a lot of the state standards.
This year, Calloway Cheer has three seniors, including Daisy Lowe, now on her seventh and last year of Calloway Cheer.
I think we're ready, and I expect us to go out there and hit everything right and take home the gold.
The girls just, you know, dove in and worked extra hard, and we've rearranged the choreography to do the best that we can without Lauren. We're gonna miss her because she added a lot of talent to our team, but the girls are determined to do their best.
Although we had an unexpected challenge, the girls say that they're nervous, but also ready to bring what they have and hopefully pull through to stay. Yeah! For Laker TV, I'm Selena Eric.
Thanks, Selena, and good luck this weekend, Laker Chew team. Well, it's a whole night of fun for the cost of almost nothing. It's coming our way, seniors. If you plan on getting your groove on at this year's 2014 prom, take advantage now of the $50 fee. If you wait until January or later, the fee does go up every month. You can pay your fees in Miss Middlebrook's room in the business hall.
After the last Hunger Games movie, fans all over the world couldn't wait to get a glimpse at this sequel to the sci-fi thriller Catching Fire. Follows the dangerous and enchanting life of Katniss Everdeen in the gladiator-style arena games. Reporter Will Van Horn gives us a preview.
Since the last games, something's different. I can see it.
What can you see?
The newest addition to the Hunger Games film series is Hunger Games Catching Fire, which takes the protagonist, Katniss Everdeen, and the world that she lives in to an even darker level.
This year, you're dealing with all experience.
In the books, it's kind of a lot more darker since they're going up against people who have already gone through what they're going through, so it's just people who have already killed each other, trying to kill other people. But at the same time, it's also a lot lighter because they get closer than the people in the first book do. So I think that'll be really cool.
Well, I was kind of disappointed with the original Hunger Games. I was expecting way too much, and of course, you know, I completely kept out of mind the whole saying, you know, the book is always better than the movie, which I've already read the entire trilogy. Just, I don't know if I want to get my hopes up too high for this. I mean, I have no doubt in my mind it's going to be good, but is it going to be better than the book?
Catching Fire has already gained a 95% approval on the film critique site Rotten Tomatoes and is out today.
Remember who the real enemy is.
If you're interested in seeing The Hunger Games, make some room in your weekend plans because you're in luck. The movie plays tonight across America, including at Murray Shuri Theater.
Well, that's all for this week's show. We're looking forward to the next 3 days week.
Laker TV returns December 6th, so until then, happy Thanksgiving.
And may the odds be ever in your favor.